situations I've been through and what really goes on in my life. All you know is what you see. Don't believe everything you see on the internet. I'm just tired of everybody's opinion. Like, y'all need to just hear the real story. Reached out to my dad, we met at the mall and some other shit. Pissed off by his tattoos cause they had the names of his other kids. Like, fuck me, I don't exist, and you acting like I'm supposed to praise you. My whole life you bought a pair of J's, now you think I'm supposed to say thank you? So when I knew I didn't need that, my mom was pissed, I was selling pills. Couldn't even afford rehab, so she put me on a doctor for if. Got on stage and fucking blanked out. I look up, I'm in a ranch now. Paid 4 months of solitary, but then y'all know it ain't a hang now. Fucking hell, hoe with no bars. I remember seeing Clay kill the staff member Jimmy with a crowbar. Hit fatty scene in Alicia's car. Came home, jumped on the scene. I look online, I'm a fucking mean. Sent you my mom, I'm a fucking mean. You don't know what I see, what the fuck you mean? I stick on a pin in my heart. Carry the shit to the charts. Even when they protested, I still got more blessings. I never diss my mom to get some attention. Take a second and listen before you give your dumb ass a opinion, you bitch. I finally got home.
Finally, I
got home from a ranch, and it was pretty miserable. I had no touch, like, I was not in touch with the internet. I did not know what was going on. In the real world, this place was far away from anything. Like, no phones, no internet, no nothing. Like, there wasn't even service there.
Nothing.
And a couple of weeks after being home, I finally decided that I wanted to meet with my best friend again.
I just missed her.
Someone who was not good for me at all. But I ended up going to her house to see her, and instantly, like, I say it was the next day, she had something over my house. We just got back to doing our old shit again. Smoking, like trying to finesse people for money, like, just doing really, really dumb shit again. So, since I was back outside the house, my mom decided to give me my phone because I was running around with Zandalee. She wanted to make sure that something happened. I could be able to call her or whatever. So I logged in on Instagram that I hadn't been on for almost 7 months now. And all these people were following me. Everyone was commenting on my pictures. I had almost like 500,000 followers. And I was like, what the fuck is this? So I went on the explore page and there was a bunch of memes that was just my face that said catch me outside. And I was like, what the fuck is this? Like, I had never, like, I never even imagined that would happen. Like, I didn't even remember saying catch me outside. That's the funniest thing. Like, until I seen the bit from the show, like, I didn't remember I said that. Like, that show was so irrelevant. Like, it was just some random ass shit. So, like, a couple weeks later, I had 600,000 followers. It was crazy. I was like, these people didn't even know if it was my real account. Like, I had never verified that it was my real shit. So,
they were just following it. Like, it's
and then my... Or, and then now, this guy Adam had knocked on my door. And I was like, can I help you? Like, what do you want? He was like, do you sing? Do you rap? Do you do anything? And he was like, well, I want to bring you to LA. So, me, I was like, LA? Okay, cool. So, I went out there, and I met Nishi, and I met Adam's management partner, Dan. And I stayed out there for a little bit. I did some interviews and did some videos and stuff. And then I went back to Florida. And me and Zizi were just, like, walking, like, the streets of, like, where it's, like, going to the beach and stuff. And people kept taking pictures of me, and they kept, like, we kept getting into fights. And, like, even some of Zizi's friends got into fights about me, and I was getting sued for it. I was getting blamed for it. So, then I hired my bodyguard, Frank, because he's a big-ass motherfucker, and he'll beat up everybody in their moment. So me and Zizi had went somewhere with one of her friends, and we ended up getting tattoos that night. And I didn't tell Adam I was gonna do it, because I didn't think he'd care. Like, I didn't think he really, like, gave a fuck. So I ended up getting a tattoo, the tattoo I have on my arm.
It says Vampire.
And I went home, and Adam had called me, and he FaceTimed me, and he seen it, and he was like, oh my god, you're going back to LA. I can't have you out here doing this. Like, you're gonna fuck yourself, you're gonna get in trouble. This is not happening anymore. So before he had sent me back to LA that day, I met this girl Gabby, who I then started dating or talking to for a couple months. And I was living with her in her trailer, and it was crazy. Like, every time I go outside, like, there was all the neighborhood kids were surrounding, like, her house. Meanwhile, my dad was trying to get back in my life, and I didn't understand why. So I told him, like, no, I don't want you to be in my life. Like, 14 years and you haven't been here. Now all of a sudden you see I have fans, followers, and all this, and now you want to get back in my life? Like, no, it's not gonna work that way.
No.
He didn't like that, so he went to press, he went to other cops,
everywhere
he went
imagine.
To news stations and other TV hosts and all this shit, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, talking all the shit he possibly could, just trying to sabotage my whole career that wasn't even a career yet. He wanted to make sure that every time I went to court, he went as well and tried to fuck shit up. He lied to the judge, told the judge I was suicidal, told the judge that I needed sexual ed classes, like, just a bunch of unnecessary bullshit. So fast forward, fuck my dad.
Like, his bitch pussy ass.
Then my manager was like, okay, let's go to this recording studio. Like, I have a few people I want you to meet. So I went there, I met this A&R Aton, and he was like, well, we have this song, we want you to record it, we want to see how you sound. And it was literally just high bitch. It was not no other lyrics, it was just a beat and the word high bitch. So we made some verses, we finished the hook, and Aton loved the song, and he was like, you know what, you're gold, I want to sign you.
Bitch, you're just mad, you think you know me, you don't. You don't know the real life situations I've been through and what really goes on in my life. All you know is what you see.